I didn't think I'd be breaking in all this equipment with so heavy a topic. Kind of defeated right now. So, I don't often talk about politics. I just really don't like what it brings out in people. So I do my best to avoid it. And my whole life, everyone around me wasn't really political, which is cool. So that might have been why I'm like this. And I find it very strange that all of a sudden it's a bigger thing. And I can see why. The world is weird, and interests have made sure that we all fiercely feel things now. And I don't even want to get into that right now, because it's not really part of what I need to talk about. The first time I realized I was politically different from my sister was after the 2016 election. I came home to vote, and when I was home, my sister walked in, just a happen chance meeting. She was there dropping off her kids or something, I don't even remember. And she said, "Oh, well, I hope you didn't vote for." To which I looked and said, "Well, I didn't vote for." And that was really the end of that. I kind of rolled my eyes and went, "Well, that was weird," and went about my life. And even to this day, I don't really talk politics, particularly with her. She got married earlier this year, and it was kind of interesting because I think it was late July, maybe early August. She was here. I'm living back at home again. Well, she was here. And it was just her, none of the kids. Her husband wasn't around. And we were all having light, happy conversation. More so than usual. My sister usually torments me. But she decided to mention something rather odd, and it was that her husband is big into conspiracy theories, and they don't hold a lot of, you know, weight into them, they just find them interesting. But then she went full on and brought it up politically and started to explain how the were Satan worshippers and they were torturing children, and I immediately recognized that rhetoric because I've heard about it. I know where it's from. I know kind of the depths of that rabbit hole. And knowing where it's from, being the Chans, I kind of looked at her and said, "That's all kind of just really poorly written fiction. You don't see it as that." And she laughed and tripled down and explained how, no, it was all a big conspiracy, Day of Reckoning and whatnot. And I stepped away from the conversation rather quickly. I never really said more to, you know, disprove. I can't disprove anything. I'm just a dude. But she, you know, continued explaining the whole thing, and I smiled and was polite, and I said, "Well, I don't believe any of that, and right on, good for you." And that was the end of that as well. But now we're getting closer to Election Day, and obviously it's been kind of heavy on my mind thinking that she's been believing some weird internet stories, which, again, I'm just a guy. I don't need to get into why that's insane. But I also didn't think it was all that big a deal. I didn't think I was really losing her to any sort of weird rabbit hole. Until today, today was a Friday. I had the day off of work, just naturally, just due to weird shifting. And I went to a car show because I own two cool Japanese cars. I've been trying to develop kind of footage using this camera and, you know, all this stuff to try to make a fun video out of introducing that. And, well, in that time, I felt the need to sit down and talk out my thoughts. But I went to this car show today, and my dad had to get my sister's kids off the bus because they were finishing school for the week, and he would have to come to the car show after me. She could drop him off. He doesn't drive. So I was like, all right, cool. Whenever you can, come on down. And then, you know, I went to the car show with my van. And about a half hour later, my dad follows. And we are just spending time at this car show at a nearby kind of just like bar and club. And my dad goes inside. And he's spending his whole day inside. And at one point I walk in, I order some food from the little food area, the kitchen area. I come back outside, you know, I walk towards the van, have a short conversation with some folks that had questions about it, because that's the fun of owning a weird vehicle. And then I realize my phone's ringing. I always leave it on vibrate. It doesn't really make sounds. I get calls all the time. We live in 2020. Every 3 out of every 4 calls, even someone who gets normal phone calls, is going to be spam. So I'm just expecting spam. You know, it's just some junk call asking about my car's extended warranty, even though that doesn't exist for an imported car. So I answer it. And it's my sister's daughter, her 9-year-old daughter. Okay. Didn't expect this. And she's laughing. I hear what I assume to be, you know, her step-siblings laughing in the background. And I say, hey, what's up? And she says, I need to say something. Okay, well, say it. I'm here. What are you doing? And she says, I heard you're supporting and you're officially removed from the family. Or, I don't know if you said removed or you're officially banned from the family or just something along that line. I was too dumbstruck to remember the words, not that I don't have a goldfish brain anyway. So, I kind of dumbfoundedly, like, I didn't even know what to say, and I heard more laughing, and she hung up. I put my phone back in my pocket and tried to process what had just happened. I was outraged. I was insulted. I was clearly disrespected, but there were a lot of implications in what had happened. The main implication that was going through my head was I can't believe that my 9-year-old niece felt the need to get all political on me. And even worse, a 9-year-old in my family is going to disrespect me over a political position that she's never talked to me about. That's weird. And then I continued to think about it, and I realized that it could only be she picked it up from my sister, who was probably saying disparaging things about my political views, despite, again, I don't talk about my political views to her. Short of, I won't vote for. It's bizarre. So, I've been severely disrespected by my family. And I say my family, my sister and her children. my dad is 100% on board with everything I've ever said politically to him. My mom's pretty apolitical. She jumps the gun on just about everything, but I don't think she really has too much of a stance as far as who's better. And that's fine. I get it. I'm not here to rush anyone or force anyone into thinking anything. I'm not an expert. I don't want to be an expert. So I just feel completely disrespected, and I think if, you know, she wants to joke that I'm kicked out of the family, because I feel like she's going to say it was a joke, even if she comes back and apologizes, which this little girl isn't the type to apologize, even if she does, I can't support the mentality that would have someone reach out to their own family and say such a horrible thing. I grew up in Appalachia. You know, it's Pennsylvania, but it's a very down-home kind of place. You know, you have family, and that's life. You know, your family is always there for you, no matter what. You know, I have family I have severe disagreements with, but if they needed my hand, I would extend it every time. But I feel like this is one that I don't know. I may have truly lost my sister today. I told my dad about everything, and I prefaced, before I told him anything, I said, I need to tell you something, and you can't tell anyone until I have figured out what I'm doing, or until I've spoken to my sister. And he, of course, said, you know, he was there, and he was happy to hear me out. And I told him the whole story, and he, again, was very agreeing with me and is behind me on whatever decision I end up making. Whereas my mom doesn't have any sort of patience with this, and I feel if I tell her, then suddenly she's going to get herself involved and there will never be any resolution to this. Best case scenario, my niece apologizes, and I always look at her with a side eye. That doesn't, that's not something I can come back from. Worst case scenario, the lot of them triple down, like I know they're going to, and I never speak a kind word to my sister again. Or her children. And I don't know if any of that is good. I don't know why I'm publishing this. Guess I just needed someone to talk to. And who can I talk to about this? If you're a good friend of mine and you're watching this, don't worry. Please don't worry about me. My relationship with my sister was always kind of strained, so it doesn't change anything other than just being hurt by something more specific this time. So don't worry about me. If you're here for other stuff, if you're on this channel for other reasons, then this is not why you're here, and you probably didn't make it this far. I'm sorry to trouble you. This being a personal channel with no real subscribers, I don't feel a need to put out consistent samey content at all, so I'm just gonna put this out there and hope no one in my family finds it. Just sucks. If I could say anything, it's take care of people, take care of each other, and take care of your family. Hopefully they've taken care of you.